In this tutorial video, we're going to learn about how to create motion guides in Adobe Animate CC. So a motion guide is basically drawing a path and then animating an object along that path very easily. So in this particular project, we've already had some layers that are pre-built just to save time. And the top two layers, we have an airplane guide and an airplane layer. So on the airplane layer, I'm going to put a movie clip, and it is of an airplane. And I'm going to pop it over here because I want my airplane to swoop in, go in a circle, go in a bigger circle, and then fly out. That would be hard to create with just regular motion tweens. But if we use the pencil tool to draw our path, we can tell the movie clip or the airplane to follow that path. So on the airplane guide layer, I'll go ahead and lock everything else, grab the pencil tool, go to properties, make sure it's, you know, it doesn't really matter what color it is or the thickness, but I like mine to be pretty thin and black just so I can see it. And then you want to make sure that it is in pencil mode, and you probably can't see that, but when you click on this, you can choose smooth. That way, whatever you draw, it's going to smooth it out. So on frame one, I'll go ahead and, well, what happened in pencil? Okay. I will go ahead and draw my loop, trying to be as smooth as possible, and then a second one, and then fly out. So the problem with this is that it has some of these bumps, and sometimes that's not too bad, and sometimes it makes it weeble wobble and it looks weird. So I'll probably undo that and try to do something a little bit more smooth. Okay, so that may or may not work, so you might have to draw that motion guide a couple of times. So on the airplane guide layer, you can right click and choose guide, and you can't see that either, but choose guide, or you can go to properties and then change the type of layer to guide here. You can see when you turn it into a guide layer, it has a little hammer. It means that it's a guide, but it doesn't have anything to guide yet. We need to tell the airplane layer to be a part of that guide layer. So we're going to click and drag it underneath the airplane guide. Even though it already is, it's going to kind of indent. So once it indents, that guide layer will turn into this kind of caterpillar looking curve. And that tells you that it is actually guiding something. So in order to make a guide work, I'll go ahead and lock it and unlock the airplane. What you want to do is you want to have your object move and have its kind of center pivot point right at the very tip of the guide. Then we want to click on Insert, Create Classic Tween, and you'll see that it kind of shifted a little bit so that it would actually be at the very start. When we look at the classic tween, it has all these dashes saying that it's broken. And the reason why is because at the very end of our animation, we don't have another keyframe, so it knows what it should look like at the beginning and what it should look like at the end. So moving our playhead over to the very last frame of this guided layer, we will click and drag and pop it again right onto the very end. So if we scrub this playhead, we should be able to see that it is in fact following the guide. So let's do Command Return or Control Enter to test the movie and see how that looks. So it looks good and it's following the guide, so it's doing exactly what it should be doing. It's just a little bit weird because it's not really following it in an oriented manner. So let's go ahead and change the orientation of this. In order to change the orientation, the first thing you have to do is on the first keyframe, click on your object, grab the transform tool, and then rotate it so that it's going in the same direction as the direction of your guide. So since our guide is moving down, we will angle our plane so it's going down. Then we move to the very last keyframe and we do the exact same thing. We click the object and then move it in the direction that our guide is moving. So let's see what that looks like. Okay, so it's weird because it's a little bit of a tilt, but it's still not quite right. But once we've set those two, what we can do is go back to our timeline, click on the classic tween, and then in the properties panel, you should be able to click on Orient to Path. Now when it goes through the animation, it will follow along the guide and actually flip and do all these different stunts because it's now oriented to the path. Let's preview this one more time. Okay, so as you can see, it gets a little bit of a weeble wobble, so I might work on making a smoother motion path, but I did a fairly complicated animation very quickly with a motion guide that would take me a long time with a motion tween. So let's see what else a motion guide can do. A motion guide can also change different properties such as color along the path and scale along the path. So in this instance, I have games, stunts, and food, and there are just three different words that we want to have guide along a layer. So let's go ahead and create our guide first. I'm going to grab the line tool, and I'm going to create a line. Well, we'll just create a line right now. Let's unlock that and lock the other one. We're going to create one line and just drag it a little bit past the edges of the stage. And then what we can do is we can actually grab the width tool. And for this particular guide right in the middle, I want it to get a little bit thick. And what that's gonna do is gonna have the word go from small to big to small again. So that's gonna give it some dynamic movement. In addition, if I change the guide to different colors, let's say for instance, I wanted to do a linear gradient, then I can have it change colors. So let's go ahead, I'll change this from white on the edges, and then it's gonna go to pink. So it's gonna change colors, and you can see this easier if you do really drastic color. So if you're trying this out for the first time, do that drastic color. In fact, we'll go ahead and change this to like a deep blue so that you can see the change that's gonna happen with that. All right, so we need, now that we have our guide, we need things to actually guide. So on this food layer, I'll come over here and I have a movie clip that's called MC Food, and that's locked, so I gotta change that. So also notice that with my guide, it is a guided layer, so don't forget to right click and make this a guided layer. And then with food, I need to click and drag. Same for stunts, same for games. I need to drag all of those so that they are all guided layers. So on stunts, I'll go ahead and, I don't even have that movie clip, so we're just gonna ignore that one for now. And then for games, we'll pop that in there. All right, so each one of these, we want to have them guided by this guide. So we'll work on food for right now. And again, we're gonna pop that right there. And we're gonna go to insert, classic tween. And I made it black because black is gonna show all the colors in whatever pure form you have on the guide layer. If you make your font white to start with, it won't show any of the colors. If you choose a color other than black, like if you made it orange, then when it gets here, it's gonna mix the orange with the pink and give you a weird color. So just know that the best thing for this is to make your font black. So just like the other motion guide that we created, it has a keyframe on the start of the guide, but it has a broken classic tween because it needs to know what you want to have it look like at the very end of the tween. So we'll go ahead and move food over here, and then it gets that solid arrow, and you can see that it is in fact moving along the guide. Right now it's just moving in a straight line, so it seems tedious because we could have just done a quick move motion tween with this. But the reason why we do this one is because now we can choose to color along the path, so you can see that it turned blue. Let me change that color or turn off that motion guide. So you can see it goes from white to pink, and then it's gonna go to blue. And then if we click on that classic tween again, we can also scale along the path. So if we scale it, we can see that it goes from small to big to small again. But notice that it's really, really, really big. And that's because any kind of change in that motion guide, this actual guide line, even though this looks really small, if you start it out or with a kind of big word, then it's gonna make it super big. So your options for this are to come over here and then click on the food and change the width and height at the beginning, and then change the width and height at the very end So we'll come over here, click on that, and change it there. Readjust it, reposition it. So, okay, now it is going to go from big to little. Oop, it went a little bit too small. So maybe we just need to undo what happened on the last keyframe. So, all right. So there we go. So it's much bigger. You only have to change it on the very first one, and then it'll go back. So that works pretty well. So again, for the games, we can do the same thing. We can move games down here, and we can make it smaller. And, oops, let me lock the food. And then grab games, make it a little bit bigger than that. Move it down. All right. So there it is, and do insert classic tween. And it's going to look broken until we change what it looks like at this point. So we're going to move it down here. And then the last thing we have to do is in the middle. We have to say color along the path and scale along the path. Now, the problem with this is if we watch it, they're going to happen at the same time. So control enter or command return. So they're going to happen at the same time, and they go really, really slow. So you're going to have to come back with those motion guides and just start changing when things happen. So let's say I wanted that to start at 10, and I'm going to move these keyframes back. And maybe I want this one to last about that long. And then I want this one to start, maybe it can start coming in about halfway across. And then bring that down. And you probably want to make them about the same visual length so that you have good pacing. These broken classic tween is just because you don't have a keyframe here, but since they're not going to be animated anyway, you don't have to worry about that. You can also highlight any of the frames you don't want, right click and choose remove frames if you needed to. So let's watch this. All right, so food comes in. Games comes in. So it looks like those are a little bit too fast, so you might want to slow them down. But that's an easy way to create complex motion using a motion guide in a classic tween, whether for movement or to actually do different property changes along that motion guide.